It's time for Blu-ray pickups of February, yes, 2020. Again, doing that whole format where I'm just going to show you everything I got all at once. I've got everything that already opened up to, you know, and checked. Let me know if you like this format. This is the second one. Hopefully I don't forget anything this time, or get it out of order, or get interrupted by a baby. lots of packages. Oh my gosh. Yeah, I went a little nuts. Not as bad as last month with the whole bin full of, you know, DVDs and such, but yeah. Let's get started so we can hopefully get this all done in one video. First up is a package! Yes, from Grindhouse Video. Now this stuff is essentially, I picked up a whole bunch of things because, you know, there were announcements that certain titles and such were going out of print. And so I looked around and picked up a bunch of things and some extras just to, you know, round it out and make shipping worthwhile. So first up, from Scream Factory on Blu-ray, The House Where Evil Dwells and Ghost Warrior. Species 3 and 4, The Awakening here. Gotta make sure we don't get that glare going. Bad Influence. Yeah, I don't know anything about that movie, oddly enough. Managed to get Green Inferno with the slipcover. Now, we didn't get... Green Inferno is distributed by somebody else in Canada, so we didn't even get this released up here and couldn't get it from Scream Factory's or Shout Factory's website at all, so you'd have to go to a third party, and luckily, Grindhouse still had the slipcover, so I was able to get that. And then they also had some stuff on Super Sales, so I picked up Ghost in the Shell Standalone Complex Second Gig Individual 11. I think this was like a couple of bucks. And then The Laughing Man for a couple bucks. I also picked up Death Wish 3 and Death Wish 4. And then finally, something that's, I believe, an exclusive to Grindhouse Video from Unearth Films, Frankenstein's Bloody Nightmare, an independent film as far as I know. Get all these things in here proper. Next up, another package! This one's from... Oh no, it's not this one. Is it this one? No. Before, that's... I think that's the horror pack. But I got a package from Shout Factory. And as you can see, it's got a big, long thing, which means... poster. And what is that poster of? Well, because My Bloody Valentine. Yeah, so I went out and did the whole order from them so I could get the extra slip, because I think they did that before and I didn't realize that the extra slip only came through them, and so I missed out on that extra slip. So yeah, poster, extra slip, My Bloody Valentine. Grabbed all of that. Wasn't on sale, but you know, such is life with that stuff. Next up is the horror packs, which you would have seen previously if you've watched those things. So we've got Johnny Gruesome, which is awesome. This is the only way to get it on Blu-ray. Only way. It's out on DVD, but if you want it on Blu-ray, you have to get it through horror pack. We got Don't Breathe. I found that after from the man himself, who, you know, writer, director. The Machine. And then finally, Michael Ironside and Steve Bauer in Mutants. Yes. Then I got another package. Now this was something I ordered from Unobstructed View because they were having a Criterion sale. Now you saw all those Criterion releases in the previous video, but maybe you caught the fact that I was missing two. Yes, well, they got me the other two. So, Straw Dogs and The Lady Vanishes from Alfred Hitchcock. Got those. So those were half-price sale they were having. Next up is a bunch of stuff from Walmart. Now, they had a whole bunch of DVDs, which were stuff from Shudder. But I didn't know if they were out on Blu-ray, because they also had this, which is Mon Mon Monsters, or Mon 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 Monsters on Blu-ray. But, yeah, I didn't know about any of the other DVD ones, so I didn't buy them. So, yeah, I'll have to look into that. But, picked that up. That was, how much was that one? That was $15. That was right in my my Blu-ray wheelhouse. Also out that month or that week, I picked up a whole bunch of DVDs. These are from, this one's from 4Digital Media. Again, these are a little bit over my price. Normally, I only want to spend at most $10 on a DVD release, but inflation, it goes up. So for $13, we got Invasion Planet Earth with the slipcover. The Lost Patrol. Now, I often don't get the non-horror stuff on DVD, but I kind of read that and I was like, that sounds interesting. I want to see that. Ouija Room. I don't know. Came with slipcover, so I grabbed it, and it's horror. Then this one's $15, but it is a package of four films from Wild Eye Releasing. Now, I looked up their website and tried to look around, and as far as I can tell, this is the only way to get all of these movies. They didn't have individual releases. I could be wrong because I don't know. I don't know much about Wild Eye up here. We don't get to see them. I don't see them in independent video stores very often, and I don't see them in any big box store. I used to see a couple every once in a while in Walmart, but now I don't see them at all. But yeah, so this is Night Howl, Apostle of Dracula, American Mummy, and Frankenstein's Hungry Dead. Yeah, you kind of figured that out, right? Werewolf, Dracula, Mummy, Frankenstein, yeah. So it's some films that are taking on the whole Universal horror thing. Yes, at the $15 price point, because it's from, no, this wasn't, this was, shoot, this was $18, so above it, but it is anime, so I grabbed it. That's White Snake. This is a G-Kids, Shout Factory release. Another one of those $13 ones. This one didn't have, DVDs. This one did not have a slipcover. It's from Vision Films. Sounded interesting, post-apocalyptic, futuristic, horror type, I don't know what the hell's going on with this. Transit 17, probably garbage, but, you know, whatever. And then finally, at $13, because it was awesome, I think this came out the week afterwards, all of these things, I could be wrong, but I think this was the only thing I picked up this particular week. The Hunt for Vlad the Impaler. I kind of looked at it and was like, do I want to get it? Do I want to get it? This is from 4Digital Media again. But it looks pretty cool. It's got some old school fighting and Vikings and all that kind of stuff, which is right up my alley. Then, some Amazon packaging. Again, continuing on with, you know, discontinued items and my purchases. We got, unfortunately, without slipcover, Jeepers Creepers Collector's Edition. Millennium and Rotor double feature from Scream Factory. Monkey Shines. And Dr. Demented. There's no doctor in front of that. I added that on myself. What else is there? We got, this may also be from, this is also from Amazon, because, you know, I think they broke up my order, I think, into like three or four shipments. Like, whatever. Jeepers Creepers 3, no slipcover. If you have that, let me know. Or any of the slipcovers I'm missing. Jeepers Creepers 2. Now, Jeepers Creepers 3 isn't going out of print, but I figured since I was grabbing Jeepers Creepers and Jeepers Creepers 2, I should have the entire series. Yes, I do not want to necessarily promote the man behind them, and because he's a very, very bad man, but I like movies. What am I going to do? Double feature here. I hummed and hawed about getting this, but it's Bolero and Ghosts Can't Do It. Mainly because there's a ghost movie, and even though it's not technically what most people consider horror, if there's ghosts, I consider it horror, so I picked it up. And because this one, I had to get this. Braddock Missing in Action 3. I don't know if I have the other two Missing in Action, so I'll have to work on that. I could. I might have it. I don't know. And then another one, don't have the slipcover. If you have it and you want to pass it my way, let me know. Dolls, Collector's Edition. And then Species 2, so I now have the entire four Species films from Scream Factory. Then these were at Best Buy. These were at Best Buy, and I was walking through there. I was looking for certain things, and these were priced at, I think it was like 10, 11, and 12, or 10, 11, and 13, or something like that. And so I grabbed it because I started watching this. Is it on Amazon Prime? I don't know. But it's from the Sci-Fi Channel. We've got The Expanse Season 1. That was the cheapest one. And then the real reason why I jumped on this was a lenticular cover for Season 2. Yeah, I got the slipcover there. Don't have it for the first season, but such is life. And then we got Season 3. It's got some raised portions and such. But this was the most expensive one because it was the newest one that they had on sale. But they were all on sale for a really good price, so I grabbed it. I'm a sucker for sales, man. A sucker for sales. From Walmart. Now, this was priced a little bit above my $15 price mark, but I love this slipcover. I was not going to pass it up. I have not seen the movie previous to this, but I have seen at least the first and second one, and that's Dragonheart Vengeance. Who would have thought this series would have made this many of them? I don't know. Whatever. And then, yes, $15 mark, Takashi Miike's First Love from Welgo. Welgo's doing it again. Give me the good price points. Love it. Then we got a package here. Yes, a package from Screen Archives. So Screen Archives was having a little bit of a sale. And, yeah, I looked at what was for sale, and I was like, yes, I'm going to get on that, because it was all Code Red and Scorpion releasing titles. So first up, we've got Lightning Bolt and the Resurrection of Zachary Wheeler. It's always good to be able to, you know, add to your Code Red library without having to pay an arm and a leg, like $40 a title. We got the Devastator. So yeah, I jumped on every single one that they had that I didn't already own. The House of Insane Women and Passion Plantation. Devil Woman and Dragons Never Die. This is a Scorpion releasing title. Nashville Girl. I wouldn't get this normally, but because it was on sale, I grabbed it. This one I would have grabbed. I have not seen it. That's The Rain Killer. And then finally, can you go wrong with a cover like this? We got Silk. Moving along. We've got another package. This package is from Shout Factory. And this was because, like I said, titles going out of print, and they had re-released, which I think may now be out of print again, Deathstalker and Deathstalker 2. I totally missed out on this when it first got released. The day I was going to buy it, it went out of print. Like, they ran out of stock, and I was like, And this was one of those titles you could only get from Scream Factory, so that was it. Couldn't get it anywhere else. So I also picked up The Dark Half, going out of print. I'm pretty sure I've seen both of these films, but anything's possible. Grey Eagle and Winter Hawk. I do like me some good engine films. Pardon my PC. Lady in White. Yeah, my native cousins would totally be on my case for that one. And then finally, I wasn't sure if I was going to grab this, but we've been watching The Sopranos lately, and I think I want to get through a lot of the, you know, mobster films, the mafia films and such with Leslie, because she's kind of drawn into that stuff. So I picked up The Sicilian, you know, because it's going out of print, and figured, you know what, grab it now before the price goes way through the roof. And then this is another package. This package is from the actual makers of this film, Ocular Migraine Productions. This is an independent film. I think this is probably a BDR to boot. But I had to get it for the 12 Days of Axmas because it's Ugly Sweater Party. Yes, it's Christmas horror. It's the only way you can get it. It'll probably never be available ever again, and that's probably not a bad thing, but still. Then we got, yes, Jesse Nelson, which would make this Diabolik DVD. So this package here, again, more Scream Factory out of print releases. As far as I know, most of them are still in print. Well, not in print, but still available. But oops, this is gonna fall over. Okay, I'll have to sit here and kind of not move. So we've got Dead of Winter, Blood and Lace. Well, I just thought it was Blood and Black Lace. Again, no slipcover, but Lord of Illusions Collector's Edition. If you have that slipcover, let me know. I'd love to get it. Then we got Sunny Boy with David Carradine. And then these ones I picked up because you just don't get the archive collection up here. I got Two on a Guillotine, Don't Be Afraid of the Dark, From Beyond the Grave, and The Fearless Vampire Killers. Or, pardon me, but your teeth are in my neck. Might be a little comedy there. Then, let's see, these were passing through a Walmart, and they had a new, I don't know what it would be, a winter enjoy your movies thing. I don't know. You know how they get those, normally they have a Christmas one or a Halloween one or a Valentine, you know, like themed things. I think they have a New Year's one that's not New Year themed, but it's like kick off the New Year with movies type. This is like their their winter, I don't know. But picked it up, grabbed this one for $8. Have seen the first film. I don't know that I own the first film. I might. But for $8, I figured I'd check this out, watch the second one. Sicario Day of the Soldado. And I've been putting off this one. I wanted to get it with a slipcover, but as soon as the price dropped from $15 down to, like, it went to 10 or 12, the slipcovers went out, and then it went down to 10 for sure, and then it went back up to 12. So I was like, you know what, at $12, I'm just going to get it. People have been saying a lot about it, and that's Brightburn. Finally picked it up. Then I saw this, and I was like, yeah, for $15, I'm going to get this complete series DVD collection of The Spectacular Spider-Man. Spider-Man Lo Spectacular. And then because we... Yes, we wanted to... Well, Leslie wanted to watch this film. And she was going to pick up the DVD... for $10. Maybe more. No, I think it was $10. She was going to pick up the DVD. And then, so I was like, you know what? No. I'll just buy the Blu-ray for $10. That's Goosebumps 2. Enjoyed it. Believe it or not, enjoyed it. Looking forward to a Goosebumps 3. I didn't think I'd ever say that, but I am. And then, just because I was picking up other stuff, I finally decided to pick up this one, which was over my $15, which I don't even think my $15 limit really counts anymore. I think I'm up to more like $16 or $17, but this was even over that. I think it was at $18. Little Monsters. And then, for the final week, release week, at Walmart, I picked this one up. It was under my $15 price point, so... Yeah, a little historical drama, I don't know, maybe some fantasy, has Daisy Ridley in it, Naomi Watts and Clive Owen, so is it good? I don't know, but I figured I'd pick up Ophelia, Vengeance is Hers. Again, this is a Hamlet tale, a tale in the Hamlet universe. It's not Hamlet, but it is, you know, obviously all those characters, Hamlet, Ophelia, etc., etc. But that is it, and I've got a whole slew of things here that are going to fall over as soon as I stand up, but let me know what, they're already starting to fall over. Oh boy. Let me know what you thought of any of those pickups this month. Should I keep with this format? Let me know down below. What did you get? Of course, by the time you see this, it will have been probably a year since I bought these, but such as, Jesus Louises. I gotta get out of here before this stuff goes everywhere. Yeah. Thanks for watching. Let me know what you thought down below. Take care. Have a good one.